From the nation's tribute to Mahatma Gandhi on Gandhi Jayanti to the Indian Ministry of External Affairs issuing an advisory to Indian citizens amid rising tensions in the Middle East, and a look at why Andhra Pradesh Deputy CM Pawan Kalyan is on a padyatra. Let's get you all the big stories of the day in this news wrap. Hi, I'm Flora Swine and you're watching the Indian Express. Let's get started. On Wednesday, India marked the 155th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, the revered leader of the nation's freedom struggle on the 2nd of October. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, leader of opposition Rahul Gandhi, and various political leaders paid homage to Gandhi at his memorial in New Delhi.
In the heart of nation's capital Delhi, tributes poured in today for two of India's greatest leaders as the nation celebrated the birth anniversaries of Mahatma Gandhi and former Prime Minister Lal Bahadur Shastri. President Draupadi Murmu led the tributes by visiting Vijay Ghat, the resting place of Lal Bahadur Shastri, offering a floral wreath and bowing her head in reverence. Prime Minister Narendra Modi followed, paying his respects to Lal Bahadur Shastri. The Prime Minister also laid a floral tribute at Vijay Ghat, honouring the legacy of the former Prime Minister, known for his slogan Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. At Rajghat, the nation's tribute continued as Prime Minister Modi also paid homage to the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, marking the 155th anniversary of his birth. In a solemn moment, he also offered flowers and reflected at Gandhi's eternal flame. President Murmu also visited Rajghat, offering her own floral tribute to the man who led India to independence through non-violence and truth. Joining the tributes at Vijay Ghat was Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla, who paid his respects to Lal Bahadur Shastri, remembering his leadership during some of the country's most critical moments. Congress leader Rahul Gandhi also took part in the ceremonies, offering his heartfelt tributes to Shastri and Gandhi, reflecting on their contributions to the nation's development and the values they stood for. Delhi Chief Minister Atishi also arrived at Vijay Ghat, where she too honoured the memory of Lal Bahadur Shastri, praising his simple yet powerful leadership. The day witnessed a gathering of India's leaders and dignitaries at both Rajghat and Vijay Ghat as they reflected on the ideals of peace, service and self-reliance championed by Mahatma Gandhi and Lal Bahadur Shastri. Their legacies continue to inspire generations across the nation, standing as timeless symbols of India's spirit. For more updates, keep watching.
Moving forward to the news from the Middle East, where tensions escalated on Tuesday night after Iran fired at least 200 ballistic missiles into Israel. Noting this development in the Middle East, the Ministry of External Affairs issued a travel advisory urging Indian citizens to avoid non-essential travel to Iran. The advisory read, "We are closely monitoring the evolving security situation in the region. Indian nationals are strongly advised to avoid non-essential travel to Iran. Those currently residing in the country should remain vigilant and stay in close contact with the Indian embassy in Tehran." The advisory further emphasized on the importance of heightened caution for Indian residents in Iran, advising them to maintain communication with the embassy for any necessary assistance as the situation remains fluid. Three people, including two pilots and an engineer, died after a helicopter crashed in Maharashtra's Pune district and caught fire on Wednesday morning. The incident took place around 6:45 a.m. in hilly terrain in the Bavdhan area after the helicopter took off from a helipad located at a golf course in the vicinity. A senior police officer said that initial information from locals suggested that there was a mist when the chopper, operated by a firm named Heritage Aviation, took off. Listen to what the fire officer said about the incident.
When we reach on the spot, we notice that there is a plane crash and the entire parts were scattered. There is a smoldering fires were burning continuously. We could able to extract three casualties, and these casualties were handed over to the police.
Amid the Tirupati Prasadam controversy, Andhra Pradesh Deputy Chief Minister Pawan Kalyan visited the Lord Venkateshwara Temple in Tirumala on Wednesday to offer prayers. Check out our report to find out why he's on this padyatra.
This is Andhra Pradesh Deputy Chief Minister and Janasena Chief Pawan Kalyan, who reached Tirumala Temple barefoot as part of his Prayaschit Diksha Padyatra. The foot march was a part of his 11-day penance over the alleged adulteration of laddus served at the Tirupati Temple with fish oil and beef tallow. On Tuesday, October 1st, Pavan Kalyan began a two-day visit to the Lord Venkateshwara temple in Tirumala. Pavan walked up the hill amidst the devotees, bowed on the staircase while taking a trip through Alibiri stairway, and reached the feet of Shivari. He made it to the Tirumala shrine with his daughters on Wednesday, October 2nd, to position himself as a protector of the Sanatan Dharma. Later, Pavan Kalyan's youngest daughter, Polina Anjani Konidela, made her formal faith declaration to secure Shivari Darshan at the Tirumala Tirupati temple. Since she is a minor, Pavan signed the documents too.
In one of the largest drug busts in Delhi's history, the police on Wednesday seized over 560 kg of cocaine valued at nearly 2,000 crore rupees. The massive haul was recovered in South Delhi's Mehrauli area, and four individuals have been arrested in connection with the case, according to police officials.
We have an international drug syndicate bust, which is 562 kg cocaine, और करीब 40 केजी थाईलैंड की मैरिजुआना, हाइड्रोपोनिक मैरिजुआना है जो कि काफ़ी कॉस्टली होती है, ये रिकवर की है। इसमें चार लोगों को अरेस्ट किया है। इनिशियल इनपुट आज से करीब 3 महीने पहले एक सेंट्रल इंटेलिजेंस एजेंसी से आया था, और उस इनपुट पे ये 3 महीने से बड़े डिलीजेंटली ये टीम काम करती रही। इसमें जो चार आदमी अरेस्ट हुए हैं, उसमें अभी तक जो रिसीवर और डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर एंड का किंग पिन है, उसका नाम है तुषार गोयल। ये वसंत विहार दिल्ली का रहने वाला है, और आप समझ सकते हैं कि पॉश एरिया का रहने वाला करैक्टर है ये। इसके साथ में इसके दो साथी और हैं, एक हिमांशु और औरंगजेब जो इसके साथ हैं, प्लस एक भरत जैन नाम का रिसीवर जो कि कुरला वेस्ट मुंबई से रिसीव करने आया था, वो भी पकड़ा गया है।
That's all for today, but before we go, here are some visuals of Prime Minister Narendra Modi participating in a cleanliness drive under the Swachhata Hi Seva campaign as the Swachh Yatra Abhiyan completes 10 years.
सर, आपके द्वारा ये खोली गई एक स्कीम है जो बहुत सारे फीमेल्स को, मतलब फीमेल बच्चों को भी फायदा दे रही है। तो जब हम बर्थ लेते हैं और 10 साल तक हम इसे खोल सकते हैं, तो सर जब हम 18+ के हो जाते हैं तो हमारी पढ़ाई में ये बहुत ज़्यादा हेल्प करती है, हमें फाइनेंशियली प्रॉब्लम ना हो, तो इसमें हम इससे पैसे निकाल सकते हैं।
देखिए, बेटी का जन्म होते ही सुकन्या समृद्धि का अकाउंट खोला जा सकता है। साल में उस बेटी के माँ बाप 1,000 रुपए बैंक में डालते हैं, साल का 1,000, मतलब महीने का 80-90 रुपए। मान लीजिए 18 साल के बाद उसको कोई अच्छी पढ़ाई के लिए पैसे चाहिए, उसमें से आधे पैसे ले सकते हैं। और मान लीजिए 21 साल में शादी हो रही है, उसके लिए पैसे निकालने हैं, अगर 1,000 रुपए रखें, समय जब निकालेंगे तो करीब करीब 50,000 रुपये मिलता है, करीब करीब 30-35,000 रुपये ब्याज का मिलता है। और सामान्य रूप से जो ब्याज होता है ना, कि बेटियों को ज्यादा ब्याज दिया जाता है बैंक से।